A very happy morning to all of you. Students, today we are going to do the second part of the chapter, that is dietary fiber of orchidophage. The chapter that we are doing is components of food. And we have done with the five major components of the food, but the next and very important component of our food is dietary fiber or roughage. Now, what is roughage? Roughage, it is the indigestible part of a plant food. Means when we eat something, like if we are eating a fruit, if we are eating anything which we have obtained from a plant, then it is always having a peel on it. It always have a skin on it. Now that skin of a fruit or a vegetable or like the grams that we eat, that is indigestible. Our body is not able to digest that. But then also it is not harmful for us. It is very good for us. It doesn't provide us any nutrient, but it is an important part of our diet. Then what is its work? Why it is important for us? Because first thing, it adds bulk to the food and thus gives us a feeling of satiety. Now what is this? Jaise agar aap pani pi lete ho to aapko bhook nahi lagti. You must have heard your mother telling you that don't drink water in between the food, don't drink water in between the food, aapki bhook mar jayegi, aap kya khaoge. So that is what? Ki the water that you drink, it gives you a feeling that I shouldn't eat more, my stomach is full. So roughage also gives you the same kind of feeling. It also gives you a satisfactory feeling that your stomach is full. So you don't eat much. Okay, the first thing is this. Second, it helps in proper functioning of the digestive system, which we also known as bowel movement. Okay, it helps in the proper functioning of our digestive system and also prevent constipation. Okay, then it helps to get rid of undigested food. Like agar aapne kuch khaya hai, like I've told you before also that it acts like a cleaning thing of our food. ये हमारे digestive system में एक cleaner का काम करता है. जो भी undigested food होता है, it just helps to wash that off. Okay? It binds with excess of bad cholesterol. See, it just prevent the accumulation or the collection of bad cholesterol. Thus, prevent us from the heart attack also. So in this way, they are very important for us. Now, the next, last but not the least and very important part of our diet, that is water. Water makes about 2/3 weight of our body. It helps our body absorb the necessary nutrients from the food and thus transport that in whole of the body. Because water makes the main part of blood and blood helps in transportation. So in a way we say that water helps in transportation of food in all the parts of the body. Now, it also helps to throw the waste from the body in the form of urine. Okay, with the urine, many waste materials like uric acid, urea, many strong acids which may, you can say, affect our stomach, they are thrown out of the body with the water. Okay, it also helps to maintain our body temperature. Okay, so in this way, water is a very important part of our diet. Fine, students. Now we have done all the components of food. Now all these components, if are present in our food, then we say that we are taking a balanced diet. Okay, if all the nutrients which we have done, they all are present in the definite amount and the proper amount in which they are needed in our diet or in our food, then we say that we are having a balanced diet. Okay, now what if we didn't get a balanced diet? We will be suffering from malnutrition. Now malnutrition, oftenly people used to say that if anybody do not get nutrition, then it is known as malnutrition. But no, malnutrition means bad nutrition. It may arise because of lack of food, or it may arise because of excess of some kind of nutrient. Like if we need, suppose, for example, if we need 1 milligram of iodine daily, but if you are taking 3 milligrams of iron daily, then you are taking that in excess, na? So that will also harm your body, and that also we known as malnutrition. Okay, so excess and shortage of anything is bad. We should have the nutrients in proper amount. Okay, students? Fine. Now, the next is nutrition value of a food. Now, nutritional value of food, what does it mean? It means that how much nutrition you are getting from the food that you are eating. Okay, जो भी आप खाना खा रहे हो उससे आपको कितना न्यूट्रिशन मिल रहा है, दैट इज नोन एज न्यूट्रिशनल वैल्यू ऑफ फूड. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, समटाइम्स वट हैपन्स इज दैट वी ईट ऑल काइंड ऑफ फूड बट देन ऑल्सो वी सफर फ्रॉम माल न्यूट्रिशन. ओके, और वी फाइंड सम काइंड ऑफ वीकनेस इन आर बॉडी व्हेन आर मदर और एनी रिलेटिव दे यूज टू आस्क, सब कुछ तो खाता है फिर भी पता नहीं क्यों लगता ही नहीं है और फिर भी वीक है. सो वट मे बी द रीजन फॉर दैट? द रीजन बिहाइंड दैट मे बी द कुकिंग मैथड, द वे इन विच वी आर कुकिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर फूड. लेट मी डिस्कस विद यू सम ऑफ दोज. लाइक फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स शुड बी वॉश्ड बिफोर पीलिंग और कटिंग. यू मस्ट हैव सीन योर मदर कटिंग पोटैटो एंड देन वॉशिंग इट, कटिंग अ वेजिटेबल एंड देन वॉशिंग इट. Okay, so by doing that, the many nutrients which are soluble in water, they are removed from that particular food. Okay, ab maan lo kisi green vegetable jo hai, usme vitamin B hai. But vitamin B is soluble in water. Ab mamma ne usko chhila, kaata aur phir dho diya, to jitna bhi vitamin usme tha, wo sara ka sara vitamin to dissolve ho gaya paani mein. To aapko kya mila? What is the purpose of having the green leafy vegetable? No purpose. It is of no use. Fine. In the same way, vegetables should not be overcooked. Means, we should not, like some people used to eat, ki it should be properly soft, it should be properly soft, cook it. So that is not the way to cook the food. Okay? So you should cook the food only up to some extent. Then, vitamin C containing food should be eaten raw. Now, what is this? Like vitamin C, I told you that vitamin C is obtained from citrus fruits or vegetables like lemon, melon, orange, all these. So these shouldn't be cooked. These should be eaten raw. Because vitamin C, it just finishes off, you can say, on cooking. Fine? Then the skin of fruits and vegetables should be eaten. As I told you before that it provides us roughage. Then refined food shouldn't be used. Like maida. Maida is a refined flour. And if we talk about the wheat flour that we use, that is not refined. So we should use not refined food. We shouldn't use refined food because usme se jo bhi important nutrients hote hain, wo nikal diye jate hain. Okay? So maida contains very less nutrients. Then we shouldn't soak the food for a longer time. Again, the reason is same. Like if you will soak the food for a longer time, then the many important nutrients will get dissolved in the water and will be washed away with water. Okay, so we should take proper care while cooking the food so as to have the nutrition present in the food in the proper amount. Okay, I hope that you all understood it. Next part we will do in the next video. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.